Shepard, I thought we could experience an afternoon of acquiring material possessions for our associates.
Shopping? I guess we could. Did you have a place in mind?
Physical proximity is unnecessary. The extranet provides a greater variety of services while retaining entertainment value. Jack has lent me his credit chip on the condition that I enjoy myself and, quote, lit it up like a girly girl.
You don't have money of your own?
I am not formally employed. I have no legal standing in Citadel space. I could turn to crime, but that would look bad on a resume.
We'll get you your own funds sometime. But today, what's first?
I believe Jeff would be surprised and pleased if I got him a gift. What would you recommend?
Start with something both of you could enjoy. What do you do together?
We interact most closely when we are flying. It occurs to me that he does not have a sky car for traveling around the Presidium. Here, the 2187 Blackout has a top speed of 650 kilometers per hour, making it the most powerful sports sky car in its class.
That sounds like it'll get Joker's blood pumping.
5-year warranty. Replacement.
No, wait!
I fail to see what is wrong.
When you buy someone a present, it's best not to bankrupt them. You want a rental.
I see. Perhaps for a day or a weekend, then.
Who's next?
You are. Close your eyes.
Are we getting married?
No. There is a jeweler on the Citadel who produces these. They're made from metals from each council homeworld. Each metal compounds with the last, making the rings stronger. He calls them victory rings. Due to material shortages, only a few exist.
Rare is nice. Unique is better.
Are you valuing me?
It's the thought that counts. And you had a good one.
I have heard that expression. That's why I recorded a resonance map of my quantum bit arrays when I had the idea. If you read my extensive log files and extrapolate from my nitrogen vacancy centers, you can visualize the thought precisely.
That's a long way for a joke, Edie.
Did I have you for a few seconds there?
Not even close. Who's next?
I was thinking of something for Liara.
No. I'm as free as the dust in the solar wind. You remember that line from Fleet and Flotilla? Shalai and Bellicus on the balcony?
I don't think I've ever seen that. Did.
What? You've never? How could you not have? Well, I know what we're doing.
For 3 weeks.
you get your lead actor to?
Hey, Shepard, over here. Thanks for coming by. Good to see you. What's up?
Out for a little R and R. You?
Zach, same thing.
Hey, Jacob, I'm out of credits.
Who are they?
The parents are MIA. Volunteered to take them on for the weekend, get their minds off things. What about us, Shepard? It's got to be a game of skill in there with our names on it.
Let's do it.
Great.
Good evening, yeah?
Welcome to Castle Arcade.
Yeah.
exalted nature.
Looking for Lieutenant Williams. Thanks.
There you are. Ready to see who's the real Spectre and who's the pretender?
Whatever you say, Williams. Line them up.
That's what I like to hear. Rules are simple. I take a shot, you take a shot. Hesitate, game over.
This shouldn't take too long.
Glamorous and beautiful superstar Spectre agent first. Sorry, as pretender next.
I'll try and go easy on you so you don't break a dam, princess.
You did not just say that.
I sure did.
Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this.
I've seen how you deal with a few drinks with it. Very messy.
Ancient history. You know, I expected better.
I'm saving my best moves for later.
Best moves? At least if you're drunk, you have an excuse for high dance.
Good luck and good evening.
are gathered here to honor the life of Thane Kratos. Thane touched each of our lives in different ways. The Councilor knew him as a hero. The Normandy's crew knew him as a brother in arms, and others as a father devoted to his son. Though his life took him to very dark places, Thane cared for the better angels of our nature. Even when he was terminally ill, he ran through war-torn streets to reach me because he knew I needed help. You all know the results of that day. An assassin, a professional criminal, gave his life for his galaxy. And now he can rest. Would anyone else like to speak?
What I remember about Thane was his confidence. He told me once about how he remembered everything, even every mistake he made. If I did that, I'd be a nervous wreck. Thane kept it under control.
It's strange, but the last word I labeled Thane with is assassin. And we covered each other in firefights. That makes him a partner.
Thane's last stand was important, but let us also remember why Thane left the Normandy. To keep his son away from a life of crime. Deeds such as these do not go unnoticed by the universe. They echo in all who hear them. That is why I am here.
Thane took himself seriously, a trait with which I did not always agree. I tried to make him laugh on several occasions. But what I interpreted as a lack of humor was masking a great effort. Thane was turning his life around, the way few organics do.
The day Thane came onto the Normandy, all Kelly and I knew about him was that he could probably kill us all with a ballpoint pen. But after you got to know him, there wasn't any reason to be afraid. He let you know where you stood. Kolyak, do you,
right decision. It was saddening to see her crew go their separate ways. But it is better than answering questions in an Alliance interrogation room. I hope this message finds you well. As for me, I had moved into an apartment on the Citadel not far from Kolyat. I think the first attack I had frightened him. I will spare you the details. It seemed very dramatic at the time. But in comparison to the Omega Relay, it was a child's game. In any case, good luck getting the Alliance to listen to you. Let's keep in touch. Shepard, if you sent a message back, I didn't get it. I suppose communications from someone of my reputation would be restricted. The irony is, I'm a danger to no one these days. I am even paying taxes on my investments. I can't expect Kolyat to do so if I don't. He is doing better. He has no significant other, and he is temperamental. But he is employed and staying out of crime. I can tell he's serious about changing. It has cost him more than a few friends. Send something back if you can, Shepard. I can only learn so much from news reports about you. I have tried a false identity to try to get this message through to you. We'll see if it works. I have good news and bad. The good news is that Kolyat and I took a few days to visit Earth.
Like the ship rises, Joel sat in the trip and stops. My skin is ground. See two tiny bodies locked by claws.
Excuse me. As I was saying, we saw a beautiful sunset in New Mexico and a scorpion eating a cricket. I wish you could have joined us. The bad news is, I fainted and struck my head. Kolyat has convinced me to stay at Huerta Memorial on the Citadel. I will be there from now on. I still don't want to die in a hospital, but it's where the doctors are. And Kolyat. I love him. That means I must trust him. Goodbye, Shepard. Let me say that now in case I cannot later.
Yes, I know that's where we met, but it was very special to me, too.
So can we expect more Elcor Shakespeare from you?
Actually, I have.
Tragically, I am dead, Rachel. Wretched me, have you. pale and tremble at this chance. That are the audience to this act.
Welcome to Silver Coast Casino.
This patriarch person you keep going on about.
What? You never heard of any patriarch?
Good luck and good evening.
Thanks so much for doing this, then. I know you're off duty.
No problem. You're out there risking it.
Vanguard picks up a backpack. Gets half of it.
Officer, someone requested my presence concerning an incident with the Krogan.
Right this way, Commander.
So, Grunt, anything you want to tell me about?
This clown wants to take me to lockup. Figured I'd give you a call and straighten this out.
Commander Shepard, I apologize for the intrusion. This Krogan insisted we contact you.
It's okay. I'll vouch for it. I'll sign any paperwork you have, officer.
Yes, sir.
What happened?
I don't know. Drank a bit, left the hospital, broke a few windows.
But you were in that hospital recovering from the wreck I encountered.
Yeah, didn't feel like sticking around.
Most people stick around long enough to, you know, heal.
Most people aren't me.
And why is CSEC here?
Guess they're precious about some broken glass.
Before I sign you up, everybody walked away from this in one piece, right?
Sure, yeah, everybody's fine. Hospital seen better days, though.
Right.
Tell me about the windows.
A couple of squad mates broke me out for my birthday. Tried lowering me down the side of the building on a rope. It didn't work out.
It's your birthday?
No, I'm Tank Brett, remember? Anyway, we got some pictures on the Krogan Memorial.
In the Presidium?
Yeah, when C-Sec got there, they were mad. Or maybe they were mad about their car being on fire. I can't remember.
Why was it on fire?
I threw my bottle of Ringcall at it. Pretty strong stuff. Went up like a bonfire. The C-Sec guys jumped out. Then I figured they didn't want it, so I took it. We didn't get very far before they shut us down. Sprayed us down with riot foam. It didn't work so well on me.
And why is that?
Because I was on fire, you know, from the car. Come on, Shepard, keep up.
Right. Sorry. So how did they catch you?
Got hungry. Bought some noodles.
Brent, you apologized to the nice man for setting his car on fire.
Fine. I'm sorry for setting your car on fire. And I won't do it again.
Good. Now, officer, I can pay for any damages that may have occurred.
That's what you've been signing for, Commander. You're lucky, Krogan. Don't let me catch you up here again.
You won't. Thank you, officer. So, how are those noodles?
A little spicy.
You're my hero.
Business.
Cerberus attacked, and I don't remember seeing you. I think I caught a glimpse of Commander Shepard fighting over by the elevator bay, though.
Well, yeah, Shepard was protecting the council, but I had my own problems to deal with. You see, I was down by the docking bay near C-Sec headquarters.
Ha ha! Commander Shepard is chasing the council! This is our chance!
Oh, shit! Cerberus!
Ha ha ha! It's Joker! He can barely walk! How's he going to stop us?
Why you should comp my drinks.
No.
Oh, come on!
I barely believe what they're saying about Shepard.
You?
I don't think so.
Okay, try not to be offended there. Look, if Shepard were here... Shepard! Hi!
Joker, you were a great pilot in a terrible life.
You don't say.
You know, there's a bond, Shepard. A wordless bond of loyalty between commander and pilot. And today...
Today, you pay for your own drinks.
Fine.
Exactly the same as the others.
Sorry we're late. Somebody forgot to pick up the cerveza.
Come on in.
That somebody was you.
Didn't say it wasn't.
So when's the game? It's about to start.
Seattle Sorcerers versus Usaru Maestros. Gonna be some intense biota ball.
Nah, it's just a good little game for troop morale. They'll take it easy.
In the middle of a war with their troops watching, they'll give it their all.
Absolutely. Have you guys seen Derek Rogers' game lately? Man, he and the Sorcerers have been tearing it up.
Esteban, the Maestros don't lose.
Have you seen Tyra Tassanis play? The woman is blue lightning.
Mr. Vega, your love of the Asari team has more to do with how they look than how they play.
Hey, that's not true. Not entirely. Besides,
you're telling me you don't got the hots for some of the Sorcerers?
Okay. Guilty as charged. Who are you backing, Shepard?
I'm not sure. What do you guys think?
Seattle Sorcerers are one of the few human b-ball teams left. They were on tour when Earth was hit. Since acquiring Donna Navapi from the Hackers, they've been completely unstoppable.
Yeah, but most of the Maestros have been playing since before First Contact. They'll win this.
I know the Sorcerers have never beaten the Maestros, but they've never been this hungry either. So, Chef, who's it gonna be?
You don't bet against the home team.
Mr. Vega, I hope you're hungry for humble pie. When has our commander ever been wrong?
Come on, man. The game started.
Yeah, he was out! You're blind, Brett! Yes, they did it! Now pay up.
Hey, why didn't you let me in on the bet?
We weren't exactly betting on who would.
We were betting on if you'd pick the winner. And everyone knows you don't bet against Shepard.
Anyway, it was a hell of a game.
Yeah, great evening. Thank you, Shepard.
My pleasure.
Tomorrow comes early. Hasta luego.
I came as quickly as I could. What's wrong?
I didn't mean to worry you. When I saw you were on the Citadel, I wanted to see you again.
We've said our farewells, Shepard.
Are we going to stand up for realities? These big picture windows remind me of our talks in the Normandy's observation lounge.
This view doesn't have quite the same effect as a galaxy of stars. But I can see where it might make one sentimental. I also enjoyed our talks, Shepard. Very much.
Hey, look what I found.
An old issue of Justicar Heroes, A2140. It says that you personally lifted 50 refugees across a raging floodplain on Nebos after smugglers blew up a dam.
That news source has been known to exaggerate.
So you didn't almost drown while saving a child who had been torn from her mother's grasp?
The smugglers were not so lucky that I survived.
Are there more stories like this?
Perhaps. You might be amused by the June 2085 issue. Justicar Solara, cold-blooded justice runs hot. It is not so difficult for me to find stories of your exploits. I think that you are remarkable, Shepard. When the vids sing your praises and call you a hero, does it make you blush? Do you agree? What do you feel?
It's humbling. But honestly, if people feel that I'm making a difference, that bolsters me, my team, and our efforts. What now?
I am content as we are, Shepard. Let us sit a while longer. Even if there is nothing to say.
Sure you want to leave that here?
I can't very well bring it back to the Normandy. I'd have nowhere to put it. This place is amazing. Puts the Prefab's back in Horizon to shame. And it has a hot tub.
Go ahead.
Cheers! Oh, this is lovely. And good for the sinuses. I might not even need my antihistamine tonight.
Your what?
It's a pill. I'm allergic to dust and cats. And public speaking. I take a proton pump inhibitor for my stomach, too. And an inhaler for asthma.
You have everything you need to stay healthy?
Just about. The only medication I can't find is sucrocapsinol. My family doctor prescribed it for my headaches.
Sucrocapsinol? That's a sugar pill, Drian. A placebo.
Oh, that sneaky bastard. And now that you've told me, it probably wouldn't work anyway. There was some scented bath oil out there somewhere. Could you grab it?
Yeah. Here you go.
Thanks. Eyes are over here and up here. Hey, do you have a loofah?
A loofah.
This is Anderson's apartment, remember? I highly doubt he has it.
Found one. Somebody left an overnight bag with toiletries and massage oils and, you know, girly stuff. Do you know who Kay Sanders is? She has great taste in adjustable massage wands.
Good night.
Good luck and good evening.
Anything?
Two more drinks and another bag of ice.
I would have thought you'd be enjoying the perks of broken fertility.
Enjoying it? There's a line of females outside my dwelling right now. They're just going for as far as you can see. I just need you out my own bathroom window. Even then, I was cornered by two more females on the ride to Chunka.
And it's just you? You're not spreading the love around?
Sure, but everyone wants their firstborn generations to be strong and fit. I'm the leader of the clan Erdner. I brought an end to the Genophage. Everyone on Kachanka wants a piece of me. And Makara's no help at all. She encourages it. I'm telling you, Shepard, I'm in no shape to fight Reapers.
Considering everything we've been through, I can think of worse positions to be in.
Trust me. I've been in every position in the past few days.
Here are your drinks. And a bag of ice.